Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And I'm just gonna start this video off with telling you guys I have COVID. I just went to the doctor yesterday because I haven't been feeling well for the past couple of days. And I just got my test results at 12:40 today. But I didn't get them physically until I got home at like 3. So I didn't really know that I had it until like around 3. But I have not been feeling the greatest. I'm sorry, y'all. I don't have no clothes on. I have not been feeling the greatest at all. Today was a little better. I'm on like day 2, I think. Really day 3. And then it said that I need to isolate the amount of days in which I've been having my symptoms, and it's been like 3 days, I think, when I recorded my, on New Year's Day, so the 1st, so from the 1st, 2nd, today the 3rd, so this is like day 3. They said to isolate. 5 days total, but I'm just gonna play it day by day. So I'm gonna have to sleep in my bed by myself. And if y'all know me, y'all know I'm afraid to sleep by myself. I'm scared of the dark, and I'm just afraid to go to sleep in general. I look a mess, I feel a mess. And I'm probably just gonna be laying down. I've been laying down, going to sleep for the past couple of days. I have literally been just not feeling it at all. I'm gonna put some of the symptoms I had in one of the next videos, but yeah. Okay, you guys, and he does not stop. Okay, he just left out. He don't wanna get away from me. He been all in my face sleep, even when I didn't know, but I did feel something was off. And even if you are just sick, I was told you don't supposed to be in people's face. So I be trying to be respectful, but he don't care. I keep telling him he can't be by me, even before I knew this, literally, like, you can't be by me. I sick, you can't get sick. He doesn't care. Can you come back? Can you please come back? Hey you guys, I'm still not feeling so well. It is like day three, I wanna say, since found out on Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay, sorry y'all, I've got a phone call. I am getting ready to clean the, I'm getting ready to sterilize in the actual living room and the kitchen. I asked him, did he have it clean out here? He told me yes, but of course it's not clean out here. So I'm just getting ready to sterilize. How do you think the germs are gonna go away if you got it completely messy out here? You can't live in nasty stuff and think that you're not gonna get sick too. So I'm just getting ready to clean while he's not here. I'm gonna use the little sterilizer Lysol thing, and then I'm gonna open up a few windows, and then I'm gonna get out the way before I infect the house even more. But I just got my groceries. My mama just dropped them off to me and had my sister to bring them up for me. So that's what I'm getting ready to do. I'm getting ready to sterilize the kitchen. I'm already started. I'm not gonna show too much because I really don't have no energy, and I still have to give y'all my symptoms on how I even found out. Right now, I'm just still, I might seem like I have a lot of energy. I'm out of breath. I'm coughing. My nose is stuffy. My stomach feels like it's gonna throw up. It's just a lot that goes along with how I feel. My head hurts, everything. I'm not complaining because I'm very strong, but at the end of the day, I do know something is wrong with me. And I'm just trying to get through it. I'm out of medicine. I'm gonna get some medicine. He gonna bring me some medicine when he gets off work. And then I'm gonna lay down. No, I'm gonna take a shower, brush my teeth, get completely groomed up. Cause maybe if I do all that, I did it last night, I did it yesterday. Maybe if I keep doing that, I'll start to feel a lot better. So I'll update y'all when I sterilize everything. I'm gonna show y'all everything I did. Then I'm gonna get out the way really fast. He's been sleeping on the couch. The perks of having a guest room, but then you use it as a beauty room, which when I move to my house, we move into our house, we are going to, I'm gonna have a guest room, so when things like this happen, it'll already, we can have extra beds and extra things like that. But he's been sleeping on the couch. He's used to it. When he gets in trouble with me, he sleeps on the couch. So he's already used to it, but I'm not gonna show y'all all the junk and mess he's acquired while being out here because that's too personal. But literally, if y'all always see me doing a cleaning vlog, it's literally because I have to clean up because literally he messes up every time I clean up. Okay, you guys, I literally am almost done putting everything away. I had to make sure it wasn't on slow-mo again. I have sanitized everything. I had gloves on and then I washed my hands and then I sanitized the refrigerator. I sanitize the outside, I sanitize everything. But when I'm done, like touching everything, I'm still gonna go back and sanitize. But literally, shout out to my mother, Tasha, whatever y'all know her by. She went all the way in with the groceries. I'm gonna show y'all some of what she got for me. Let me flip the camera around. Okay, you guys, she got the 42K, box of chips instead of the 28 or 18. We normally get the 18. But shout out to her because she went in with these groceries. I got some. I didn't order these. She got them for me. I hope she didn't just accidentally leave them and give them to me because she eat those. But I eat them too. But I think she just threw them in for me as a little surprise. Pretty much clean.
I am getting
ready to disinfect the couch and get my happy black self back in my isolated area so that I won't continue to infect everything if I haven't already. I want to just make absolutely sure I'm gonna disinfect the doorknob, everything that I touch all over again. I already did the microwave, everything. I haven't touched the microwave again, so yeah. Without further ado, I'm gonna disinfect the couch and get back in the room. I need to eat something, so I'm gonna come out a little later when I'm done taking all my meds, and yes, I am sweating. Y'all probably can't see, but I'm sweating. So it has been a task.
Almost like it didn't happen to make you happy. You telling me you falling out of love for me. Hope you can find someone to love you better than I did. You telling me you falling out of love for me. Hope you can find someone to love you better than I did. It's my love for my grandmother made me gentle when I care for you.
Okay, you guys, I'm fresh out of the shower. Apologize for the view in advance. This is the best setup I can come up with. I'm getting ready to eat my yogurt, grapes, blueberries, and my banana. This is just what I want to eat right now. I'll probably eat some hot food later, or I might wait till dinner. Might eat some chips. I don't know. But, you guys, after I get out of the shower, I kind of start to feel a lot better, but then it slowly comes back. Like when I was cleaning up earlier, I just got very weak. And yeah. I'm not complaining, because I can almost bet that I feel a lot better than someone else would feel. But the thing is, why I'm taking mine just as serious as a non-mild case. They never did tell me whether mine was mild or non-mild, but I have other medical conditions, so I really was not supposed to. I was supposed to avoid this at all costs, but things are unpreventable sometimes. But so far, I feel like I could be better in the next maybe 1 or 2 days. Last night was horrible for me. I kept getting up. I was coughing. Something was like stuck in my throat. Speaking of that, I'm finna tell y'all the symptoms I had now. I keep forgetting to tell y'all the symptoms that I was having. So for maybe about 2 or 3 weeks, I haven't really been able to, had no appetite. I've been forcing myself to eat. I was telling my boyfriend in those 2 or 3 weeks, I was like, I've been having to force myself to eat. Then it played like tricks on me, like, no, that's just something that I'm saying. But then I was starting to really feel like I had to force myself to eat and stuff. Fast forward, aside of the loss of appetite, not knowing what I wanted to eat, when I did eat, I started feeling like I wanted to throw up, but I could never bring myself to doing it. So I was like pushing it off, like, okay, maybe it's because I ate too much, which I wasn't eating too much. I also got a really bad breakout on my back, and then it's like spread
all over my body. I don't know if that's related to this, but I was just like itching. Resting, I don't really think that's related to this, so I'm not gonna get into that, but so maybe within the last week is when I really, my body was like, okay, pay attention to me. And the little throw thing sitting in the bottom of my stomach, it's not really in the bottom, it's like in the middle of my stomach, was like, okay, I'm coming up closer to where I need to throw up. And I was like feeling very bad, but I still didn't think nothing of it. So I got this cough, and then my throat got really dry, really, really dry. I could not, okay, maybe Monday of this week, today's Thursday, Monday of this week, went out to work. No. Before I went to work, that morning, I went to our guest bathroom because my boyfriend was in this bathroom. And normally he go over there, but that's besides the point. So I'm like, okay, I'm just going to use the bathroom over there. I'm sitting on the toilet. And I just start, like, some nasty smell got in my nose. It wasn't for me. I just feel like that was my way of telling me, okay, it's time to throw up. I don't remember what it smelled like. I don't know. It was like a weird smell. I got up. I couldn't even finish wiping. But I'm like, I don't want to be on the ground, on the floor, without wiping. So I literally heard, I was literally, it just happened in literally 2 seconds. And I could not bring myself to throw up because my throat was so dry. I didn't have any liquid in me to come out. So I let that go. I went to work. I was not feeling good at all. Me and my mama got into like a little, the people in the store like did the food, standing over me, like, just know they were doing the food. They're standing over me. And normally when I look back on it the next day, my mama was like, you really didn't feel good yesterday, because keep in mind I went to the doctor that same night. They tested me for two things, one related to one of my medical conditions, and then the other one was COVID. So the other one, with my medical condition, came back. There was nothing wrong with me with that, but then I still had to wait on the COVID test. So she like, you really didn't feel good yesterday, because you didn't say nothing, you didn't do nothing to them people. They was ready to fight, this, that, and the third, the two managers at the store. And I'm like, okay. Then I have to re-look back at it. I'm like, you know what? You're absolutely right. I didn't feel good at all. I literally could not do anything. My whole body was weak. She can tell you I was pushing myself. I'm like, okay, come on. You gotta go. You gotta come on. You gotta come on. You gotta come on. But my body was just not accepting that. Like, it was telling me something was wrong. Fast forward, the next day we went out again to work. I felt a little better. I went to the doctor, like I said, that night. Next day I felt a little better, went out, did some errands, and I got dropped back off at home. Me and my boyfriend went to Popeyes. We came back. I was checking my KP app, Kaiser Permanente app. I was checking the app all day for those results. Nothing. So something just told me to check. It was like around, I want to say, 2 or 3. Boom, I decided, let me check, because I don't want to go into the night not knowing. Even though I'm like, I don't got COVID. I know I don't got COVID. I'm just sick. This around the time I get sick every year. I check it, and it tells me that I'm positive. So far, you guys, I've experienced nausea, lack of appetite, lack of taste, smell, stuffy nose. You guys can hear how I blow my nose literally like a million times a day, and I'm not even lying. Coughing, sneezing. I'm so tired. Ooh, you guys, within those 2 or 3 weeks, I have been completely tired. It was a point where I was riding in the car with my boyfriend, and he was talking to me, and I couldn't stop myself. I'm like, he's like talking to me, and he like, you don't hear me talking to you? And I'm looking, and then at that point, I'm looking at him, but I couldn't say nothing. I was too tired. Anyways, this is 7 minutes and 30 seconds, so I'm going to cut this clip out. I mean, cut this clip off right here. I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog because it's not really much I can show y'all. I've been washing my hands. I've been disinfecting everything. I've been putting my mask on. I've been isolating. I've been trying to stay hydrated. I've been walking. I've been moving around. There's not really much I can do. For the most part, I've been blowing my nose. But you guys, thank y'all so much for watching my video. And down below, please let me know if you guys ever had COVID and what are some of the things that y'all did to get over it.